In this video, you will learn how to ascend a rope with jumars, how to remove gear from traverses, and how to lower out from a pendulum point. Following an aid climb is different from following a trad climb. Instead of climbing the rock, you will use jumars to ascend the rope. It is much quicker and easier to remove the gear this way, and it means the leader doesn't have to be there. Instead, they can organise things and haul the bags. To follow an aid climb, you will need to girth hitch your daisy chains to your harness and clip your aiders and jumars to them. Jumars are made in a left and a right side. You will need one of each. Open the catch and slot the jumar onto the rope. The jumar will lock downwards and slide upwards. Jumars are not full strength attachments. It is super important to use a backup of some kind. A common method is to use a gree-gree. Most of the time, you'll also be tied into the end of the rope. Adjust your daisies so your jumars are within reach and stand in appropriate steps of your aiders, keeping your weight on your legs, not your arms. This is harder on steep ground and takes some practice. On a vertical wall, you should be able to move as if you're walking up some stairs. You'll probably find this easier if your feet are in different steps of your aiders. You might find that the top jumar slides up the rope, but the lower jumar does this. Feather the catch slightly and it will slide up. You can also use this technique to move down the rope. Feathering the catch is a subtle movement. You don't need to open it up completely. If the rope doesn't feed through your gree-gree, make sure to pull it through every now and then. You can also add further backup knots on your belay loop if you want. This is most useful for controlling the rope when it's windy. When the leader has finished a pitch, the follower packs away the haul bag while the leader fixes the lead rope. The leader then sets up the hauling system and the follower releases the bag. Because communication is often difficult on a big wall, it's important that the leader fixes the lead rope before setting up the hauling system. This way, the follower knows the lead rope is fixed if the haul bag starts moving up the wall. The follower can then leave the belay. Pull all the slack out of the rope. Remove the anchor and up you go. The follower cleans the pitch while the leader hauls the bag. There are a few ways of arranging your jumars so that you don't end up with your jumar stuck in the gear. One method is to move your top jumar above the piece. With your weight on the lower jumar, remove the upper and reposition it above. Another way is to just unclip the piece. This works well on straight up pitches. You may have to jumar up one move so you can reach to remove the gear. Another way is to reposition both jumars above. Weight your grigri, move both jumars above the piece, and then release some rope through your grigri. You may also need to jumar up one move to reach the gear. You'll find this technique especially useful on diagonal or overhanging pitches. Another way is to simply pull the gear out and swing if it is safe to do so. To clean a traverse, you'll need to clip into each piece of gear instead of jumaring the rope. Just clip across, adjust your grigri, add a backup if you want, and remove the gear as you go. If it held the leader, it'll hold you too, right? If it doesn't, you'll fall safely onto your grigri and backup knot. If the leader has done a pendulum, the rope will be doing something like this. So when you're following the pitch, you can't just unclip the pendulum point, or else it'll be a disaster. Clip into the pendulum point. Remove any gear you want to keep, and get tight on your grigri. Then, feed a bite of rope through and clip it to your belay loop. Pull the slack through and do not let go of the rope. You should end up with this. There should be enough friction so you can just lower yourself out hand over hand. When you get to the end, unclip the rope from your belay loop and pull it through. This technique works well for short lower outs, but for longer ones, or if you don't have much rope available, you'll need to use the following technique instead. Begin the same way, get tight on your grigri, then tie a backup knot immediately below your grigri. Untie from the end of the rope and feed it through the pendulum point. Pull all the rope through until it reaches your backup knot. Then tie a munter hitch on your belay loop and get tight on that. You should end up with the rope going from the anchor into your gree-gree to your backup knot through the lower out point to a munter hitch on your belay loop to your hand. Lower yourself out using the munter hitch. When you get to the end of the rope, just let go and pull it through. Tie back into the end and continue up. Practice this stuff in a safe environment before climbing a big wall. Thanks for watching.